Today, I want to tell you about the hardest metal on Earth, chromium. As usual, let's see where chromium is in the periodic table of chemical elements. Oh, there it is, hiding behind the vanadium in the sixth group. And yes, I did not deceive you. It's true that chromium has the highest hardness of all metals, based on the Mohs scale that shows the resistance of a mineral to scratching. Externally, pure chromium is a lustrous white metal that does not tarnish in air. To demonstrate the main feature of chromium, namely its topmost hardness, I'll scratch an ordinary silicate glass with it. As usual, you cannot fool physics. Chromium easily scratches the surface of the glass, leaving a clearly discernible markings. Also, I think that the hardness of chromium is very much dependent on its purity. Metallic chromium is obtained from the chromium ore mineral by reducing it using carbon to produce ferrochromium, an alloy of chromium and iron, which is used in production of stainless steel. We will now turn to the chemical properties of chromium, which this metal is highly enriched with. Even the name of the metal, chromium, comes from the Greek chroma, meaning color. This name came to pass due to the fact that chromium compounds can have almost all the colors of a rainbow. In laboratory, the most common chromium compound is potassium dichromate. It is used often in analytical chemistry or to clean chemical dishes from the very suborned dirt. Also, this substance is used as an intermediate compound in the production of chromium metal from ore. If you mix the potassium dichromate with any reducing agent, for example aluminium powder, and then ignite it, you'll see a very violent reaction that will produce particles of chromium metal. Potassium dichromate is very soluble in water. In this compound, chromium has an oxidation state of +6. If you add a little bit of alkali, i.e. sodium hydroxide, to the orange solution of potassium dichromate, in an alkaline environment, the dichromate will turn into chromate and become yellow. In the oxidation state of +6, chromium may have a yellow and orange color, depending on the acidity of the environment. However, that's not all. If you add acid to the solution of potassium dichromate and also any reducing agent, for example potassium metabisulfate, there will be a reaction in which sulfur from metabisulfate will donate electrons to chromium and will be restored to its trivalent state, therefore changing its color to green. Compounds of trivalent chromium have a green color. This is possible to prove with another reaction. In order to do it, let's take another orange chromium compound, ammonium dichromate, in which chromium also has an oxidation state of +6. Now I'm igniting this orange powder, and what do we see? Ammonium dichromate started decomposing by itself, forming a dark green substance, chromium oxide. Due to the fact that formed chromium oxide has a porous particle structure, it begins to occupy a larger volume, and over time it might seem that this green substance is being formed just out of nowhere. I'm sorry to disappoint you, but there are no miracles. Chromium oxide simply forms with nitrogen and water vapor that are also formed during this reaction. As a result, from a small amount of ammonium dichromate, we got a whole pile of chromium oxide in the form of a dead volcano. Fun fact, this reaction is actually called the volcano of ammonium dichromate. The resulting chromium oxide is better not to throw away, as it can be easily used to make a gooey paste, in which the chromium oxide is the main component, as an inert abrasive substance. The chromium oxide has some unusual properties. For example, if you fill a flask with ammonia gas and then add some red hot chromium oxide, in such conditions, ammonia gas can react with oxygen, which under normal conditions does not occur. In this reaction, the chromium oxide was the catalyst for the oxidation of ammonia in oxygen. Also, the chromium oxide can oxidize ethanol to acetic aldehyde. If you simply light a piece of a cotton wool impregnated with ethanol, the alcohol will just burn out. However, if you scatter the chromium oxide over it, it will limit access to the oxygen in air. When using this substance, it's possible to observe the residual glow. This glow is caused by the oxidation of ethanol on the surface of the chromium oxide, so-called catalytic oxidation, in which the ethanol is oxidized to acetic aldehyde, which has a rather specific smell. This smell is very similar to the smell that can be felt in the morning after a hangover, as the ethanol in our body is also oxidized to acetic aldehyde. In addition to the trivalent compounds, chromium can also have divalent compounds, for which we will now conduct another experiment. Let's take a test tube and pour a solution of potassium dichromate in hydrochloric acid into it. Then we will add a few granules of zinc into the tube. During the reaction of zinc with the hydrochloric acid, atomic hydrogen is formed, which restores chromium from hexavalent state to trivalent. As a result, the solution gradually becomes green. Atomic hydrogen is an extremely strong reducing agent, and because of that, it gives away another electron to the chromium atom, resulting in it becoming bivalent, and the solution acquires a bluish color. This color exactly is what the divalent chromium compounds have. So, now we have a whole set of colored chromium compounds of different oxidation states. True, that's not all. Chromium compounds can also be used for another colorful experiment, to create a flag in a test tube. To conduct this experiment, we'll need a solution of potassium dichromate. Next we need diethyl ether. Diethyl ether has a low density, so it will float on the surface of the solution of potassium dichromate. Next, add a small amount of sulfuric acid solution to our mix. And to start the reaction, add a few drops of 20% hydrogen peroxide into the test tube. After adding the hydrogen peroxide, a very interesting transformation occurs. Fluid between the layers of ether and potassium dichromate becomes dark. When potassium dichromate and hydrogen peroxide react in acidic environment, an unstable compound is formed, chromium oxide peroxide. That compound decomposes immediately in an aqueous solution and gives the middle layer of the liquid this dark color. However, in organic solvents, such as diethyl ether, chromium oxide peroxide can be stabilized, and for that reason, the upper layer has a blue color. I have no idea what country would a flag with these colors belong to, but the reaction itself is quite colorful. However, when conducting these experiments, it is worth remembering that the compounds of hexavalent chromium are extremely toxic. But at the same time, compounds of trivalent chromium are macroelements in our body, such a two-phase is chromium. Pure metallic chromium is often included in the composition of stainless steel that has up to 30% of this metal. The fact is that the metal chromium is very resistant to the oxidation by air's oxygen due to the tiny and very durable oxide film that covers the metal. The same film of chromium oxide is formed on the surface of stainless steel that protects the metal from further oxidation. At the end, we can say that in its pure form, chromium is a very hard metal, though at the same time having a huge range of compounds with a variety of colors. Now you know a little bit more about one of the other metals. If you would like to support the continuous production of science videos like this one, please support channel on Patreon, link in the video description. Please like this video and subscribe to my channel to see many more new and interesting videos.